Let's do it, man.
You wanna play drums?
I'll play drums.
My name's Shaun. I play guitar and sing in Seether.
I drum like a 3-year old.
Yeah.
With his first drum kit, like behind his wall. Like John's son. Except John's son, 3 years old, has more rhythm than I do.
When you're a little kid and you're dreaming about this kind of thing, that's always what it seems like. It's just gonna be a dream, you know? Started playing in little cover bands as a kid and then learned how to play guitar and then sat at my radio for years listening, you know, playing Nirvana songs and Rage Against the Machine songs and just kind of would just go through until I could play an album from start to finish, and then I would move on to the next one, and eventually started writing songs, I guess when I was about 15 or 16, and then from then on, once I'd started, it was cool. We started off just driving to shows, obviously, like in your cars and getting there and unloading your guitar, and like, you know, most often we would take our own PA, set up the PA while the patrons of the restaurant or whatever we're in are having lunch, and you can't make noise, so we'd have to wait until 5 o'clock till the lunch rush was over, we could quickly do a sound check, and then, you know, we'd play the shows at 8 or 9, 10 at night, and then when you're done, you'd have to pack up the PA yourself, you know, because it was our PA, so we'd pack it up, throw it in the trailer. The drummer and I would drive, and Dale and my brother would lie in the back, and then we had the trailer on the back of that, so it was like, you know, those are the days when we had like, we didn't have much money at all. We used to eat like bread and mustard because it was all we could afford. You know? And then we came to the States and started again from scratch and basically had an RV and beat the crap out of it. We basically limped it back to the dealer and said, thank you very much. And then got our first bus. And
this is the sardine can itself. You'll notice, interestingly enough, we have three rows of three bunks on each side, front and back, which in total, if your math is as bad as mine, 12 bunks. And we have 13 people in the band and crew, so we don't know where the 13 person's gonna sleep yet. This little slice of heaven down there, that's me.
Then you start playing clubs and you're playing like 200-300 seaters and gets a little bigger as time goes by, hopefully, which did for us. And then, you know, then you have singles come out, and every new single kind of brings a new surge of people. This tour is great because it's like 10,000 people a night on average, and you know, it's a good rock show. If I was a fan, you know, I would feel like I was getting my money's worth.
You too can have sexy hands like these. I felt my finger gouge into the string. I was kind of wussing out. I was kind of pinkying out when I was playing today. I was doing
it's
the most polite way.
Music, you know, I can hear it in my head and I know what I want. That's why it's so satisfying, because I can get to what I'm going for.
It doesn't look as cool as I want it to look. You know, it doesn't go from the picture in my head to the canvas. It goes to something else. I'm kind of like really good at like taking a bunch of oil paints and just smushing them around and making it look something like them. And if you stand about 100 feet away from it, you can kind of see there's something there. You have to stand back, and I think that's the thing. I think the further you get away from anything I paint, the better it looks. Kind of a diary sort of thing. Every song has like a story behind it, or an experience really behind it. So I draw from what I've been through because it's all I know.